When we think of mutations in our DNA, our first thought is that it's something bad, and we fear their potential to cause illness or disease. However, this perception overlooks the crucial role mutations play in our evolution. Charles Darwin's theory of evolution by natural selection highlights how mutations serve as a fundamental force driving evolution by introducing variabilities within populations and thus allowing for evolutionary change. These variabilities can be good, bad, or indifferent. One example of a good mutation is a peppered moth. Moths are typically gray or white in color. But during the Industrial Revolution, a mutation occurred that turned some of these moths black. The black moth thrived compared to their gray or white friends because they were much better at camouflaging against the blackened trees that protected them from predators. On the other hand, mutations can be harmful as well. Has anyone here seen a white squirrel? I've seen one once in a park. It's a beautiful creature. Animals with this white pigment is caused by a genetic mutation called albinism, which prevent them from producing melanin, leading to a lack of pigment in their hair, eyes, and skin. While albinism itself doesn't necessarily affect the animal's survival directly, it can increase susceptibility to harmful effects, such as exposure to sunlight causing skin cancer, or impair their ability to camouflage, making them more vulnerable to predators. That's why albino animals are quite rare. So next time when you're strolling through a park, it'll be your lucky day if you can spot an albino squirrel. My name is Kelly, and I'm a master's student at McGill University. My project focuses on distinguishing mutations that affect motor movements from those that do not. My research centers on episodic ataxia type 6, also known as EA6. EA6 is a neurological disease that affects people of all ages. People with EA6 often have episodic spells of migraine, discoordination, and imbalance that can last from minutes to hours or even days. We're currently collaborating with a neurologist in New York who's working with a family spanning three generations experiencing EA6 related symptoms. It is a debilitating disease, but currently there's no cure. Therefore, understanding this disease is crucial to developing better treatment options for patients. This disease is caused by a mutation in a protein in our brain called ET1. ET1 is a transporter for chemicals in our brain. If you think of neurons as houses, transporters are like the doors to the house. These doors are specific to different chemicals, meaning that only certain people are allowed to enter your house, assuming you don't let strangers come and go as they please. As you can imagine, if this door is broken, even if you're allowed into your own house, you may not be able to open the door. What I want to know is not only which mutations can break this door down and which ones can't, but more so is what are the consequences of this door being broken. From a public database, we have found a list of mutations in ET1 that are present in patients with EA6. But we can't be certain if EA6 is caused by any of these mutations, because just as we discussed before, some mutations can be good or bad, and some may have no effect at all. Perhaps EA6 is caused by something other than these mutations, so we need to test them genetically. To do that, we need a model organism. I'm sure you often heard of scientists using mice, guinea pigs, or even monkeys to study biology. But those species take a long time to even test a couple of these mutations. I'm going to use the fruit fly as my model organism to do the same thing that you can do in mice and guinea pigs, but in a much shorter period of time. After all, time flies like an arrow, and fruit flies like a banana. Did you know that around 60% of the fly's genes can be found in humans in a similar form? More so, fruit flies share 75% of the genes that cause diseases in humans. I bet you're not going to look at a fruit fly the same way the next time you see one. They may look nothing like us, but genetically, we're not so different. Fruit fly is an excellent model to study genetics, especially these mutations, because it just so happens the E1 protein that I was talking about, the door to your house, fruit flies share the same DNA that make that protein as us. So this means that I can study the human version of this protein with different mutations in a fruit fly, and it could potentially tell us more about how these mutations affect people suffering from EA6. Since EA6 causes motor dysfunction in humans, I'm looking for the same motor behavior in the fruit fly larvae. These larvae normally crawl a lot, like a worm, and my goal is to see that by adding human E1 mutations into their nervous system, if they're still able to crawl normally. From the 16 mutations that I'm studying, around half of these mutations cause the larvae to be unable to crawl. Either they don't crawl very much, or if they do, they crawl very slowly. If you think about what the symptoms of EA6 are in humans, where they can experience discoordination and imbalanced movements, this very much can correlate to the larvae that can't move normally. Interestingly, the family in New York with EA6-related symptoms have one of the 16 mutations that I'm studying. This family includes a paternal grandfather, a father, a son, and a daughter who experience migraine, tremor, and hemiparesthesia, meaning that they feel pins and needles in half of their body. Before our collaboration, it was unclear if it was this mutation causing this family's symptoms or if it was something else. By testing this mutation in the fruit fly larvae, I found that these larvae can barely crawl. This mutation affected their movements so much that they're almost completely paralyzed. In other words, this mutation affects the function of the E1 protein, as if the door is broken and you just can't open it anymore. We are also collaborating with other labs to figure out why this door is broken and how we can potentially fix it. Our results have provided valuable insight, confirming the role of this mutation in causing this family's symptoms and guiding potential treatment strategies. In conclusion, while mutations can have varying effects, their study, particularly using model organisms like fruit flies, offers invaluable opportunities to unravel the complexity of genetic disorders and pave the way for therapeutic advancements. Thank you for your attention. And remember, even the humble fruit flies can offer significant insight into human biology.